Jesus Christ. My name is Hisham Shahab. We are today at St. John Lutheran Church in Schaumburg, Illinois. We have with us Rahim from Iraq. Rahim Al-Hassan from Iraq, and we would like to talk to him about how he came to America and how God called him to faith. سؤال الأول سيد رحيم لألك هو كيف جيت على أمريكا؟
بداية رحب بكل بشر شاهد هذا الفيديو.
First, I want to welcome the viewers of this video.
And أكون ممنون للقس هشام.
And I am very grateful for Pastor Hisham for this opportunity. أعطاني هذه الفرصة
من أجل أن أنا أعرفه على أموري الخاصة.
I am very grateful that Pastor Hisham is introducing me to talk about some personal issues which are important.
الطريقة اللي جيت بها على أمريكا إنه كان ابني الوحيد يعمل مع القوات الأمريكية في العراق.
My son used to work with the American forces in Iraq, and this is how I came to America.
So, بدت كل الناس اللي تشتغل مع الأمريكان من مترجمين مساعدين طباقين قوات احتياط كلها كانت معرضة للتهديد من قبل بعض الأحزاب الإسلامية بداخل العراق.
All those people who worked with the American forces in Iraq, whether they were cooks or guides or translators, what have you, were threatened by the terrorist groups, Islamic terrorist groups in Iraq, and my son was one of them, and he was granted an immigration visa to come to the United States.
بالمناسبة ابني كان الوحيد من عائلة متكونة من خمس بنات وابني الوحيد وزوجتي وأنا.
And noteworthy is that my son was the one among, I mean, in the family who worked with the American forces. He was the oldest son, and I have five daughters, and my wife and myself.
أخذ رأيي إنه ممكن بابا إنه أشتغل مع القوات الأمريكية. فوافقت بدون أي تردد.
When he asked me first whether to work with the American forces, before he really did join the American forces, I agreed without any hesitation.
الحكومة الأمريكية من شعرت أنه أكو ناس راح يتعرضون للخطر بسبب اشتغالهم مع القوات الأمريكية أصدروا قانون اللي إلى رغبة بالمجيء لأمريكا.
So the American authorities knew that people working with them are threatened and their life is in danger. So they opened the door for them to immigrate to the United States as refugees.
في هذه الأثناء طلب من عندي إنه ابني أن يتزوج من العراق.
And he asked me to get married also in Iraq.
لهذا
my son.
تزوج. ابني بالعراق وأنجبوا بنت لطيفة داخل العراق.
So he got married and they had a baby girl in Iraq.
ورا فترة معينة أخبروا ابني أنه تستطيع أن تأتي إلى أمريكا.
Then he was told that he can come to America after he did the documents needed for that.
ايضا وافقت بدون تردد.
So I also agreed without hesitation.
لهذا جاء ابني ب 2010
الى So my son came to America in 2010.
Yes, شهر 11.
November.
5/11.
November 2010.
اجى ابني لامريكا وكان يعبر لي موقف عن وضعه هنا وعائلته زوجته وبنته. بعض الاوقات مرتاح بعضها مو مرتاح بسبب البعد بسبب فراقه عن الأب والأم وهكذا
so تغيير النظام. There were social issues when he first came. He felt kind of ostracized from the family. He felt isolated and he had some nostalgia for Iraq.
في إحدى الأيام قال لي رايح على الكنيسة Bible Church.
ويتن بايبل تشيرش.
ويتن بايبل تشيرش. هناك بالكنيسة التقى مع قس اسمه كريس.
So one day he told me that he's going to church and Wheaton Bible Church, I believe, and he met with a pastor called Chris there.
بعدها بعد ما زار الكنيسة هناك سيدة محترمة اسمها جولي تبرعت لخدمة هذه العائلة.
So after he went to church, a lady there called Julie volunteered to help his family really through their life in the United States.
بعد ما عينوا له أنه السيدة volunteer ذات نام جولي اسمها جولي بدأت الحياة بشكل آخر للعائلة.
So life started to get better because of Julie, and she was helping very much in their daily life.
Julie have two girls, and all the time together, my son, my and wife, and everything needed, Julie help him go to the office, transit to my son. So كانت هناك علاقة جدا طيبة.
So there was a very good relationship between Julie and her family and the family of my son. So after a while, what happened?
بعد فترة زوجته أصبحت حامل.
Also, his wife became pregnant after some time.
And
gave birth to a baby.
Baby, and asked me by telephone, what the name to this baby? I told him Julie.
So yeah, I advised him to call her Julie after the volunteer.
Yes, Julie, because Julie, nice woman.
Okay.
So Julie. كانت جدا فرحانة اللي نسمينها.
So Julie was very happy because they called the baby girl after her.
بعد هذه الفترة اقترح علي انه شنو رأيك انه ممكن تجي هنا؟ قلت له لا بأس.
Then he suggested to me to come to America myself. I said why not?
Okay. فعمل لنا بعض الأوراق الأصولية وتمت مقابلتنا. أنا مع زوجتي مع اثنين بنات عندي.
So he applied for us and we were interviewed in the embassy with the adult girls daughters I have.
تمت مقابلتنا بالسفارة العراقية السفارة الأمريكية ببغداد وتم التشيك الأمني والتأكد من كل شيء صغيرة وكبيرة وتمت الموافقة علينا للمجيء إلى هنا.
So after checking on us and doing the security check, they agreed to give us the refugee status in the United States.
لكن كانت زوجتي مريضة بمرض السرطان. لهذا السبب وصلنا إلى أمريكا بواحد يعني أقصد شهر 4 يوم 1 2014.
But my wife was sick and she had cancer, and we arrived in April 2014 to the United States in Chicagoland.
بالمطار كانت هناك المنظمة IOM باستقبالنا. ابني وعائلته عندي بنتي بويسكانسن أيضا هي وزوجها لأن زوجها أيضا يشتغل مع القوات الأمريكية. كانوا باستقبالنا مطار أوهير.
So my son and my daughter who lives in Wisconsin with her husband who also worked with the American forces before that welcomed us at Chicago O'Hare Airport.
My son lived ابني كان يعيش بمنطقة Elgin.
And my son used to live in Elgin
yes.
Township.
من وصلنا للمطار كنا كلش فرحانين انه نلتقي بابننا وبنتنا.
We were very happy because we were united with my son and my daughter who lives in Wisconsin.
لحد الان الاخبار جيده والامور تجري بشكل طبيعي.
Everything was going well.
لكن انتكاسه زوجتي بسبب المرض كان شرح كبير لنا ومحزن.
Then my wife had a setback in her health and that was a tragedy.
ايضا فولنتير ماي سان يعني مساعدة ابني انتقلت الى نورث كارولينا.
Okay, Julie who used to help my son's family moved also to North Carolina. So two things happened.
Yes. اتصلنا بالمستشفى وقضينا معظم الوقت بالمستشفى.
So most of the time we spent when we arrived was in hospital to deal with the health issue of my wife.
بمعنى احنا وصلنا يوم 1/4 ودخلت مستشفى يوم 2/4.
So she really was hospitalized one day before our arrival.
لم نرى من أمريكا أي شيء معين.
We couldn't see anything, you know, in America, just hospitals and just going back home.
كان المستشفى والعاملين في المستشفى بمنتهى الإنسانية والخدمة الجميلة لنا.
We were very impressed with the way the hospital staff were dealing with us in a very humanitarian way without any discrimination or anything.
ولكن الأطباء أخبرونا أنه الكانسر متأخر.
But they told us that the cancer is terminal.
Yes. لهذا السبب طلبنا من عندهم وراء 10 أيام رقود المستشفى أنه تغادر. فانطونا إجازة 7 أيام إنه نطلع من المستشفى.
So they told us it's pointless to stay in the hospital and she was discharged.
أخذنا زوجتي المريضة الوسكانسن بقينا 3 أيام عندنا بنتي بوسكانسن بقت 3 أيام ورجعنا وأيضا رجعنا على المستشفى. بعد وصلنا 1/4 توفت 11/5.
So almost 40 days after our arrival, she passed away, my wife.
كان حدث مؤلم جدا.
It was very tragic. Very tragic.
Yes. بقينا سوينا إجراءات الوفاة وطلبت من عندنا أنه نرجعها للعراق.
And her will was to be buried in Iraq, so we
أخذها.
Went and buried her in Iraq.
أخذها ابنها على العراق. هناك تمت مراسيم الدفن وبدينا نرجع لنفس الكآبة الأولى.
So we went back to the United States and lived in very sad situation. No wife, the head of a household, you know, and the family was very bereaved.
بقينا بالبيت ما نطلع خارج البيت ما عندنا لغة ما عندنا إجازة سوق ما نعرف أي شيء الولد أخذ المتوفية وذهب إلى العراق إلى أنه في إحدى الأيام جينا لكنيسة ويتين بايبل تشيرش.
So we stayed at home, we couldn't go out, we have no, we couldn't speak enough English. One day we were invited to come to Wheaton Bible Church. هل هو word relief اللي دعاكم؟
No.
مين اللي دعاكم على Wheaton؟
ابني اتصل اتصلت عليه وهو بالعراق قال ممكن تروح على الكنيسة.
So my son who was still doing the burial procedures in Iraq called me and he said why don't you go to Wheaton Bible Church?
لم نتصل بالمنظمة اطلاقا.
Okay.
أبدا. فبالكنيسة التقينا بشاب إنه قال ممكن أنتوا تجون يوم السبت لكنيسة.
مين هو الشاب؟
أسامة.
Okay. In Wheaton Bible Church we met a guy who goes to Salam Christian Fellowship in Lombard and he said why don't you come on Saturday?
Saturday جت علينا سيارة أنا وبنت بناتي ثنتين. ورحنا إلى كنيسة السلام والتقينا بالقس هشام وكان أعز لقاء وتفرجت الدنيا لنا لأنه المجتمعين بالكنيسة يتحدثون لغتنا يقدمون الابتسامات فارتاحينا لأول يوم.
So that Saturday, a bus, a van came and picked us up from Elgin and drove us to Lombard to Salam Christian Fellowship. And we were very, very happy because we were among people who speak our language, and they were very friendly, and life started to change to the better.
Yes. أخذنا القيس معظم أو كل أعمالنا الإدارية والورقيات كلها أنجزها القيس وأدخل بنتي إلى المدرسة مواعيد الأطباء قراءة الرسائل أي شيء الإجازة السوق بواسطة كنيسة السلام.
So Pastor Hisham and Salam Christian Fellowship were able to take over all our social services, our documents, and our also correspondence, and take us to public administrations, and was able to put enroll my daughter in school, and we were able to stand on our feet again.
نسينا أيام الحزن أيام الوفاة نسيناها بسبب هذا الجمع اللطيف وننتظر السبت بفارغ من الصبر.
So our life changed to the better, and we started to forget the melancholy and sadness, and we used to wait for Saturday impatiently because of the happy time we spent at Salam.
تعلمنا خطوة خطوة بواسطة السلام.
Step by step we were able to learn about the Christian faith.
بعد سنة بعد سنتين تزوجت إحدى بناتي في نورث كارولينا.
After 2 years, one of my daughters got married in North Carolina.
And another زوجت في also in North Carolina.
And another one also got married there.
And I watch. كنت أراقب الكنيسة وأراقب القيس. كانت يحشون صدق إنسانية خدمة البشرية بإنسانية. كنا نعيب على وضعنا داخل البلد بالعراق. يعني شفنا غير عالم، عالم لطيف، عالم يمتلك الإنسانية والمحبة.
So I watched how the church was dealing with my family and helping my family and my daughters, and I saw how there is a big contradiction, if I can say, between our life in Iraq and the way people behaved there and the way people in at Salam Church dealt with us in a very humanitarian way.
أراقب عن كثب ما يقومون به وبقيت متلاصق مع الكنيسة ابتداء من 2014 ولحد الآن.
So I started really getting attached to the church, and since 2014 until today, and watching closely how people from Salam deal with other people, with their neighbor, how they love their neighbor.
المفصل الرئيسي اللي حدث ب 2020 جانوري 17 جانوري كان مفصل جدا رائع وراقي بالنسبة إلي. اتصلت بالقس هشام وأبلغت أنه لدي الرغبة أن أتحول للديانة المسيحية.
In January 2020, I called Pastor Hisham and told him I want to embrace the Christian faith, and that was a very important kind
date.
Of decision in my life.
تفاجأ القس.
The pastor was surprised.
طلبي من القس بعد مرور بحدود 6 سنوات.
So I asked the pastor for to be baptized after 6 years of arrival in the United States and meeting with Salam.
الآن تغيرت تغير جذري. تعلمنا من الكنيسة التسامح الحب.
I started to change radically by learning from the church how to be forgiving, tolerant, and love other people.
رغم أنه تعلمنا من بعض الكتب المقدسة الإنجيل الشيء البسيط رغم ان بساطه الاشياء تعلمناها لكنه كان اكو تحول بالداخل.
Even though we learned very simple things from the Christian faith, like love your neighbor as yourself and love God with all your heart, you know, but it was enough to enact a very internal change in our heart, a very important and radical change, as he said in Arabic, جذري, radical change in my heart.
الديانة الوحيدة اللي بها محبة إنسانية خدمة بدون مقابل صدق الديانة اللي تعلمناها من
I felt that Christianity that I learned at Salam is the only religion that has love and forgiveness and human position towards others unlike other religions.
فتحت لنا أبواب كثيرة. كان القصد من التحول للديانة المسيحية ليست لأهداف دنيوية بقدر ما هي إيمان بالسيد المسيح.
I did not embrace Christianity to get anything from the church or the pastor. I just wanted to know and meet Jesus Christ and love him and serve him.
دفعني بالإيمان أنه أنا ما مطالع كتب عن السيد المسيح العهد القديم العهد الجديد. دفعني الإيمان هو الدليل القاطع بإنسانية البشر الموجود بالسلام واللي التقيت بهم كلهم. فسألت نفسي يعني ممكن هؤلاء الناس بهالإنسانية بسبب أخلاقهم له أو بسبب إيمانهم بالمسيح؟ فتبين لي لا، إنه الإيمان بالسيد المسيح هو السبب.
I what made me believe in Jesus Christ is the way I saw followers of Jesus Christ behave, because I asked myself, are they good people or Jesus is good and he changed their hearts? And I arrived at the conclusion and understanding that because of Jesus Christ, they are doing these things, and the power of Jesus Christ is giving them the power to forgive and love other people.
الخلاص أنه ما كنت أعرف سابقا أنه السيد المسيح أفدى دمه من أجل الآخرين.
I didn't know before that salvation is through the blood of Jesus Christ. We didn't know that at all about the Christian faith before.
حمل خطايانا.
And I learned at Salam that he took our sins.
هذا الخلاص وإيماني المطلق. الشيء الثالث.
And so it's by faith that Jesus Christ took our sins on the cross for our salvation.
السبب الثالث. أنا من بيئة شرق أوسطية ألتقي برجال الدين بالطبع ليس كلهم لكن معظمهم ما يقوله بعكس ما يفعله.
I am from the Middle East as you know and I've met many Muslim clerics and there they said things different from what they did but لكن شو المقارنة هون؟
مقارنة لا يقول ويفعل يقول.
So
عندهم الإنسانية.
There is honesty in dealing with people through the church. That what they said, if they are able to do it, they'll do it. لكن هيدا الأمر اللي قلت ثلاث أشياء اللي هن خلوك تقرر إنك تتعمد. أول شيء.
ملاحظتي.
سلوك المؤمنين بالمسيح كيف حولهم قلبهم السيد المسيح ولأنه المسيح أخذ خطايانا على الصليب
من والفرق
وكمان الفرق بالتعامل مع الناس بين رجال الدين من أديان أخرى ورجل الدين أو المؤمن بالمسيح الذي غير قلبه السيد المسيح وأعطاه قوة من خلال الروح القدس يتعامل مع الناس.
أنا خلافي مع الديانات الأخرى ليس بسلوك الناس لا، إنما بجوهر اعتقاداتهم.
Let me say that my problem with other religions not only with the behavior but also with the core beliefs they have about their religions.
مثلا صوم ودخلك للجنة، سوي هيك حتى ادخلك، يعني ديانات الاخرى ديانات شرطية بشروط قاسية.
What I learned that or observed that the other religions are conditional. They have conditional love. While in the Christian faith there is unconditional love, it's not love that expects a give back. Like as he said, you have to fast and pray to go to paradise, but God loves us unconditionally, and this is really what really drew my heart to Jesus Christ.
الديانات الأخرى تنظر للأشياء بقشورة.
So the other religions are superficial, I believe.
ليس بدواخلها.
Not really, it doesn't look deep inside the heart of the human being. في كلمة أخيرة بدك تقولها للمشاهد.
ودي يعني أحث العالم على المسيح وقراءة سيرة السيد المسيح والاهتداء للسيد المسيح. ما عندي مشكلة ويا المسلمين بقدر ما عندي مشكلة مع النظام الإسلامي، نظام متحجر نظرته للأمور نظر متحجرة بعكس بعض الديانات.
I would like to urge other people to read the Jesus Christ and the Gospels and see how the difference between Jesus Christ and how Jesus Christ loves us unconditionally in comparison to other religions where they are fossilized and they want you to do this or that and where love is conditional. And I have no problem with Muslims, but I believe that Islam is fossilized and cannot really give people their human needs, if I can say.
عندما تذهب على سبيل المثال لطبيب ما تسأل هذا مسيحي هذا كذا بقدر ما تسأل هذا خبير أو لا. فإذا الشغلة الإنسانية فوق كل شيء.
So I believe human rights and human needs are above what we may call divine, because Jesus Christ treats us as brothers and sisters, not as slaves. Last few words, when I met Rahim, and after 6 years he came and asked me to be baptized. Rahim is 63, right?
No, 66.
66,
yes.
Sorry. So he reminded me of Nicodemus, okay? And I called him Nicodemus, really. And if you go to Salam website, you'll see a newsletter about that. And I'd like, before praying, to read the words of the Gospel of John. Now there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him. Jesus answered him, Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. So, as Rahim said, you know, nobody can do these things unless God is with him. We cannot do this on our own. We cannot love our neighbor as ourselves on our own. We need the power of the Holy Spirit to do it. And this is exactly what he was talking about, that only God can do this. And he realized that it's not because people are good. We are all sinners. But because of the love of Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit, we are able to love our neighbor as much as we could and serve our neighbor. And let's pray before we part. Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving your Son on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins. We thank you for opening the hearts of people and make hearts of stone become hearts of flesh through your word, the word that it's mightier than a double-edged sword. We ask you, Father, for peace in the heart of people in the Middle East, and ask you to make them shed all the shame they have and look at Jesus Christ, that who'd free them, because as he said, you'll know the truth and the truth will set you free. We thank you for your support and pray that God will bless you and keep you. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen.